Hello wonderful person, this is Anton, and today we're going to be talking about a potential resolution to one of the mysteries coming from right at the center of the Milky Way galaxy. The mystery that was originally discussed a couple of years ago, or I guess more like a year and a half ago, when a team of scientists from UCLA University announced the potential discovery of a completely new object referred to as a G-object, something that wasn't really a star and something that wasn't really a cloud. It was basically something in between. And at least five of these peculiar objects have been discovered in the last few years, with several teams trying to figure out exactly how they're formed and what exactly they represent, as they essentially orbit extremely close to the central black hole known as Sagittarius A star. But now, following a thorough analysis and actually a few different observations from different teams, there are a few propositions, with one being very, very interesting. A proposition that might explain their origin and how these objects exist. But in the last month or so, there have been actually a lot of intriguing and interesting discoveries coming from this region of space, basically extremely close to the center of the galaxy, extremely close to Sagittarius A star. A lot of these recent discoveries are mostly based on the observations from this observatory located in Hawaii that's been looking at the center of the galaxy for at least a decade, actually over a decade. And it's these years and years of detailed observations that first of all allow the scientists to establish that there is definitely something in the center of our galaxy. And the team that officially announced this a couple of decades ago ended up winning a Nobel Prize last year. But more importantly, some of the recent discoveries sort of confirm that it's most likely an extremely massive black hole and not really any other phenomenon, for example, some sort of dark matter or any other unusual exotic object. Actually, one of the most recent papers analyzed the motion of some of these stars in the vicinity here, creating the most accurate map of the motion of stars in the vicinity, allowing the scientists to work out where most of the mass is distributed. And it looks like approximately 99.9% of all of the mass is right at the center, suggesting of course that it's very likely a supermassive black hole. Then this other study we've recently discussed also used a computer simulation using a supercomputer to try to figure out what happens to a lot of different types of stars when they approach a supermassive black hole like the one in the center. And it looks like certain stars, like the ones like our Sun for example, do actually have a chance to potentially survive this event and reform into a typical star-like object. This was of course one of the potential explanations for the existence of these G-objects. And then some of the first official explanations since the original discovery back in like 2011 involved a binary star system. With the overall explanation suggesting that, well, maybe some of the binary stars that got a little bit too close to the black hole because of the tidal interactions with the black hole might have actually come closer and closer to one another and eventually combine into a larger chunk, a larger object. But because this process would most likely be kind of messy, it would also leave behind a somewhat large and thick cloud around these binary stars, making it to some extent resemble some sort of a stretched cloud-like object with something really bright on the inside. Which would be a really good explanation for what we're seeing right here. But there was a problem with this. More and more of these objects were discovered in the last few years, and it just didn't make sense that so many binary stars seem to be existing in this region, and that all of them for some reason seem to end up producing these unusual objects. On top of this, when a star, no matter what kind of a star it is, passes close to the black hole, we do expect at least some of the material to sort of make it into the black hole and then produce the emissions we usually observe from various black holes. The emissions that usually also turn the black hole in the center extremely bright. This is actually precisely what was expected to happen back in 2012, but as the scientists observed the star pass very close to the black hole, they realized that nothing occurred, and this is when the mystery was officially born. They realized that these seemed to be extremely different objects. And so something is definitely keeping these objects compact and is preventing them from falling apart completely. And because they do tend to have relatively close orbits to the black hole, with an average orbit being around 100 to maybe 1000 years, this sort of implies that these types of objects seem to only exist extremely close to different massive black holes. And so that's how we come to this new study that tries to once again resolve this problem by watching these objects a little bit longer and also trying to see what's inside of them as well. The study is as always in the description below. Now in this case, they basically focused on like a decade of observations of that one original object known as G2. And the images in the paper sort of give you a good idea of why it's so difficult to try to understand what these objects are. All of these images basically give us just a few pixels to work with, and that's because of the distances involved. The central black hole is over 25,000 light years away from us. It's pretty far, and there's also a lot of gas in between us, so it's somewhat difficult to detect this. And one of the things that were confirmed in the paper, and were also confirmed in several other papers, is that this object seems to have a relatively constant temperature, no matter what happens to it. So basically, it stays a little bit hotter than it should be. Or in other words, it seems to have a temperature much closer to what you would expect from a very hot star than a large cloud or a small star. And this suggests that in this case, the black hole doesn't seem to have much influence on the temperature of this object, because most of the heat seems to be created by the object itself. And when they did a more thorough analysis of the object itself, its heat, and the shape, they realized that the best way to explain this is by having three very hot, very young stars in the middle that seem to be also shrouded by a relatively thick cloud that's probably just leftover gas from the interaction between stars and possibly some other matter. In some sense, very similar to a typical triple star system that's just being born, usually only a few hundred thousand or maybe a few million years old, with some extremely hot stars in the middle and a tremendous amount of gas around them. But in this case, because there's no massive object next to this particular object, it sort of forms into what you would call a protoplanetary disk. However, by being so close to the central black hole, it seems to sort of misshape this object and turns it into something a little bit different, something that we're referring to as a G-object, something that's a little bit more spaghettified. And so, essentially what the study suggests here is that these are three evolving, very young stars, and it means that they were most likely produced in the region less than a million years ago. Suggesting, of course, that there seems to be some sort of a star-forming mechanism that seems to happen extremely close to the central black hole, and it most likely forms not just one or two stars, it seems to form clusters of stars, with all of these G-objects possibly representing the remnants of a young stellar cluster that was basically broken apart by the mass or by the gravity from the central black hole. But the actual star formation and the formation of the cluster very likely took place extremely close to the center of the galaxy. And if this is actually correct, it would make this a pretty interesting discovery. First of all, suggesting that stars do form very close to black holes. Second of all, it sort of allows us to study some of the youngest stars in this region, with stars basically less than 1 million years old. But would also create a kind of a new mystery. The mystery of how are these stars able to be formed in this region. A lot of scientists today believe that a lot of stars are unable to form very close to massive black holes, because once in a while these black holes become extremely active and start emitting so many galactic winds that this sort of prevents any star formation in the vicinity. But we also know from some of the recent studies that our black hole was actually relatively quiet for the past million years or so, with the last possible emission we've discussed in one of the previous videos being just under a million years ago, and that seems to correspond to the age of these stars. So there is maybe a chance that once the black hole became much more quiet, it sort of allowed some of the gas to start coalescing into stars and also start creating different clusters. But obviously, because of the tidal interactions, eventually this would fall apart into smaller pieces, with many of these pieces then forming these unusual G objects. And some other pieces forming some other objects that have also been identified to be relatively young. For example, there's another type of an object that's been discovered a few years ago known as an S object, also known as S stars or S clusters. And a lot of these S stars have been known for about 8 years now and seem to be also relatively young objects that are somewhat difficult to explain. But they're different from G objects in that they don't actually fall apart in the same way. With the main suggestion now being that, well, maybe all of these objects did come from some sort of a central cluster that basically fell apart because of the tidal forces and then created various objects around the black hole. But because this is a relatively big proposition, it would definitely require some follow-up papers and a lot of additional observations. Mostly because, once again, a lot of scientists don't think that black holes or the vicinity of black holes can actually produce any new stars because of these other effects. However, if this study is correct, it would provide us with an excellent opportunity to figure out what happens to various galactic centers in between massive eruptions from central black holes. So maybe that's actually when a lot of star activity and star production starts. Maybe a lot of these stars were born after that last emission we've discussed in a previous video. Or in other words, maybe all of this is sort of connected. But for now, I guess that's all I wanted to mention in this video. Check out all of the relevant links in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, subscribe if you still haven't, share this with someone who loves learning about space and sciences, and maybe come back tomorrow to learn something else. Maybe support this channel on Patreon by joining the channel membership or by buying the wonderful person t-shirt you can find in the description. Stay wonderful, I'll see you tomorrow, and as always, bye bye.